LandFX has a vast library of patches for almost any surface. If you have patches that LandFX doesn't, you can save them into your database and make them accessible directly through LandFX. To begin, you will want to save your hatches into AutoCAD. To do this, make sure all of your custom hatch pattern files are saved and organized in a single location. It is recommended that all of your pattern files have a standard naming convention. Once your pattern files are organized, you will want to open LandFX and either type options in the command line and press enter, or select the options button from the FX drop-down menu. Here, you can select the Files tab, then select the Support File Search Path section. Click the Add button to create a new path, and then click Browse to specify the folder. Now, when you use the AutoCAD hatch command, you will see your custom hatches in the list. To integrate them with LandFX, you will want to run the Print Hatches command by typing Print Hatches in the command line and pressing Enter. Select the category of hatches that you wish to print and click OK. This will generate a drawing that contains all of the hatches of the chosen category on a template. To save your custom hatches, open the Last Layout tab with an available space or create a new one and copy any of the previously placed hatches into an available spot. You'll now have a duplicate version of the hatch you copied. Go ahead and make as many duplicate spots as you might need to accommodate your custom hatches. You can then use the existing hatches as a template for placing your custom hatches. Select one of the duplicate hatches and you will see the hatch creation ribbon. If you expand the pattern section, you should see your custom hatches in the list. Once your custom hatch is selected, go ahead and adjust the scale and rotation to your liking. When the hatch looks good, fill out the pattern file name, the hatch display name, the scale, and the rotation. When you have all of your hatches laid out on the template, you can save the drawing for future use. Finally, you will want to save the hatches into the system. Do this by adjusting your CAD window to a 4:3 ratio. 3 inches tall by 4 inches wide is a good example. It is important to do this so that your hatch will get an appropriate preview slide. When the screen is adjusted, zoom in on the hatch you wish to save so that it fills the screen. Then you can select the Save Hatch tool from the Hatch drop-down section of the FX Site ribbon. Select the desired hatch, select the library you wish to save the hatch to, and click OK. Click OK to confirm the pattern name. Now you will see a dialog box that allows you to see the pattern name and a thumbnail preview of the hatch. The Hatch Description field is where you will enter the hatch display name. You can also confirm the hatch scale and rotation. When everything looks good, click OK. Repeat this process for each custom hatch. Once you have saved your hatches, they will appear in the respective hatch libraries under the User tab. If you wish to rename your User tab, simply navigate to your LandFX Hatch folder. Here, you will see a user XML file for each hatch library that you have saved a custom hatch to. Open the XML file for each library that you wish to rename the user tab for in a text editor, such as Notepad. In the XML file, you will see a row titled Block Filter, and you will see that it is named 0-User by default. The 0- is what the system uses to order the tabs, so if you wish to rename the user tab to Office Standards, and you want it to be the first tab in the list, you can rename 0-User to 0-Office Standards. If you wish to add another user-defined tab, simply change the block filter row for any of the listed hatches to your desired name, then save the changes. Now when you open the Hatch Library dialog box in CAD, you will see your custom hatches and they are ready for use. For more power tips like the one you just watched, head on over to landfx.com/powertips.